Good morning. I'm Dr. David Stout, the proud president of Brookdale Community College. Before we begin, I ask everyone to join us in the recitation of the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. On behalf of the entire Brookdale Community College, we gather today to celebrate the achievements of our class of 2020, our 50th graduating class. Your accomplishments reflect your hard work, perseverance, and dedication to achieving your goals. Your support network, family, and friends share in this very special day. At the start of the 2019-2020 academic year, we could not have foreseen how our world would change with the impact of COVID-19. Despite numerous challenges and changes in routines, you continued on your path to attain your goal. It's a credit to your character that you have made it to the finish line today. Congratulations, and I know the best is yet to come from each of you in your academic and professional pursuits. This year, 1,764 students will earn their degrees and certificates from Brookdale Community College. The graduating class includes 839 members who graduated with various honors and distinctions, including 244 distinguished scholars, 279 members of the National Society of Leadership and Success, 164 students representing the Alpha Phi Theta chapter of Phi Theta Kappa. Three students were members of our sixth cohort of NASA STEM Fellows this year, Chris Bedios, Haley Prelich, and Marie-Nicole Canisia. This year's graduating class includes 19 international students from 12 countries, Brazil, Colombia, India, Israel, Korea, Pakistan, Portugal, Russia, South Africa, Tunisia, Turkey, and Vietnam. The class of 2020 also includes students who participated in study away experiences that saw them travel to domestic and international study locations, such as Australia, England, Germany, Japan, Hawaii, Scotland, and Spain. The athletics program once again had an outstanding year with many impressive individual achievements. Here are a few brief highlights. Our women's soccer team finished third overall in the National Junior College Athletic Association National Championship and earned the tournament's Sportsmanship Award. The women's soccer team were Region 19 champions and Garden State Athletic Conference champions. Eight student athletes earned Garden State Athletic Conference Player of the Week accolades. Another eight received all-region honorees, and another 11 were named all-conference honorees. One student athlete, Jada Trotta of the women's soccer team, earned NJCAA second team All-American status. As impressive as these achievements were on the field, Brookdale student athletes are among our best ambassadors through their engagement in our local communities. They balance their academic, family, and work obligations to contribute to several community service projects. Our student athletes donated 83 pounds of food to local food pantry, participated in the Clean Ocean Action beach sweep in Asbury Park, and conducted clinics with local Little League programs. The Jersey Blues pride of our students' athletes was on full display as they helped organize a mental health awareness program and participated in breast care awareness through Pink Zone Night. Congratulations to all of our athletes and coaches, especially our women's soccer coach staff, who were named North Region Staff of the Year by Division III institutions. I would like to acknowledge members of the Monmouth County Board of Chosen Freeholders. Our freeholders are strong supporters of Brookdale's mission and play an important role in our students' success. Our freeholders are Thomas Arnone, Director. Susan Kiley, Deputy Director. Freeholder Lillian Burry. Freeholder Patrick Impreveduto. And Freeholder Nick DiRocco. We look forward to hearing some remarks from Freeholder Director Arnone and our Freeholder Liaison Lillian Burry today. I'd like to thank members of the Brookdale Board of Trustees for their dedicated service to our institution and our students. Our board members include Ms. Tracy Abbey White, Chair, Mr. Daniel Becht, Ms. LaTanya Brennan, Ms. Suzanne Brennan, Dr. Henry Cram, Vice Chair, Mr. Paul Krupe, Ms. Lauren Deinhardt, Graduate Trustee, Ms. Madeline Ferrero, Ms. Barbara Hall, Mr. Brett Kaufman, Ms. Marta Rombaud, and Dr. Lester Richens. I would also like to acknowledge the following individuals: Lauren Concar, President of the Alumni Association; Thomas F. Hayes, 2020 Honorary Degree Recipient; Roy Lamana, 2020 Honorary Degree Recipient; Sheila Wexler, Class of 1978 and 2020 Distinguished Alumnus; Kevin Garrison, Class of 1994 and 2020 Distinguished Alumnus; Dr. Patricia Gallo, Grand Marshal; Professor Art Marshall, Grand Marshal. I also want to acknowledge those graduates of our early college program as well. We welcome and honor the inaugural class of graduates in our early college high school program from Asbury Park High School, Wall Township High School, and Raritan High School. Congratulations and welcome to the Brookdale family. I also extend greetings and congratulations to our partners and graduates from St. John Vianney and Neptune High Schools. Please help me welcome Freeholder Director Tom Arnone and Freeholder Lillian Burry to say a few words on behalf of the Board of Chosen Freeholders. Chair Tracy Abbey White to greet the graduating class of 2020 on behalf of the Brookdale Board of Trustees, and Graduate Trustee Lauren Deinhardt to present the first ever Brookdale Community College Triangle Award.
Good morning. And welcome, family, friends, and graduates. It's an honor. My name is Freeholder Director Tom Arnone. And it's an honor to stand here and look at the graduates, and more importantly, the 50th graduating class of Brookdale Community College. As a freeholder, there's some very special things that we do and we recognize and we're part of. And one of probably the most important components of being a freeholder is to be able to have a part of our future. And when I say a part, I mean a part probably financially and maybe just supportive, cheerleading-wise, to our graduates and, more importantly, all our students that go through Brookdale. You know, I always look at Brookdale as something that, as a freeholder, we tout. And, you know, as you talk as of an elected official, you have to go out and you have to show why you should be an elected official and the good things that occur in your tenure. And I can assure you that myself and my fellow freeholders, Brookdale is at the top of the list. And when we tout Brookdale, we're able to say the great students that we have there. And you know, we can tout it, we can recognize it, we could financially support it, but it's actually each and every one of you that make it happen. You know, first I want to thank the administration, because without the great administration that we have and the teachers that we have and the support staff that we have, that also is a huge component. You know, obviously this is a unique year, a year that I actually never thought I would be part of. I've been in government 24 years and I never in my wildest dreams would have thought we'd be going through the times we're going through. But you know, when you take a look at it, and as our graduates today, you're gonna look back and it probably wasn't the best end of your year that you could have had, but I can assure you, and I feel very strongly, it made you stronger. And I know it did. You know, Monmouth County is a very special place to live, year in and year after, and it's from the people that were way before me, the people that are current here, but more importantly, it's our future. And our future is sitting here, is in these seats. And if we didn't have such a bright future, that we know Monmouth County is in great hands, it would kind of be somewhat discouraging to sit up on that freeholder board, because we would know maybe all the good work that is being done before us currently, and we know is coming in the future, would be somewhat of an issue. You know, the one thing I always say to graduating class is, you know, you'll go in maybe 20 years from now, 25 years from now, maybe who knows when, and you'll be sitting in a meeting room, you'll be sitting in a business room, you'll be sitting somewhere, and you'll come across an individual, and you'll engage in a conversation with them, you'll engage in a deal, a negotiating deal, and you'll realize, wow, that individual went to Brookdale. This is going to come across a lot of course of your life. You all are going to move on to your different careers or to another institution, but at the end of the day, you'll know your start came from here, Brookdale. And I guess lastly, all I can say to you is thank you. You have made Monmouth County, and more importantly, Brookdale, the best possible institution that we could possibly ask for. So congratulations to the graduates, good luck, and we're very proud of you.
Good afternoon. I'm Freeholder Lillian Burry, and as the longest sitting Freeholder, I have witnessed the many changes at Brookdale Community College. Changes that have made Brookdale more accessible to the community at large. Today, under unusual circumstances, we celebrate the achievements of 1,673 graduates. We are proud of you. What I'm about to say, I entitled A Time to Be Hopeful. Welcome to the new world as the first generation of explorers, standing today on the digital shores, gazing at a world of limitless possibilities. Do you hope to get a job working in an office? 75% of the people polled who are now working from home say they want to keep doing it, at least part of the time. With the rise of telemedicine, going to the doctor will take on a whole new meaning, and visits to an office may be a thing of the past. Do you see yourself in the travel and leisure industry or other aspects of hospitality like restaurants and bars? There are 660,000 restaurants in America, and it's projected that more than half will never reopen. Retail has been moving online for years, and many brick and mortar retailers are likely not to survive. So this is a time to be hopeful. All of these things are of the past. People have grown accustomed to being part of them, and their loss will present a difficult set of challenges, but not for you. You stand ready without the burden of loss. The new world ahead awaits you for to help and to invent it. There are many uncertainties, but each comes with opportunity. For 75 years, America has moved on a steady forward path that at times may have been uneven, with obstacles that needed to be overcome, but it has been an overall process of incremental growth and progress. This year marks an inflection point. The incremental growth and progress that I mentioned, the gradual is giving way to the sudden, and the future has come directly upon us. This is your future. You have been preparing for it. Now is the time to go out and make your mark on it. While many things have changed, the will to change has never been greater. This can be a new age of invention, discovery, and creation. It is your age. Go and make the most of it. On behalf of my fellow freeholders, allow me to recognize your outstanding president, David Stout. Despite these challenges and these times that we're in, he keeps Brookdale Community College on a steady course. The class of 2020 will have a lot to remember, but most importantly, you did it. Thank you.
To the students, friends, parents, faculty, college leadership, and distinguished honorees who are joining us today, welcome. And to our guests of honor, the Brookdale Community College Class of 2020, congratulations. Today is a momentous occasion. Each of you has achieved something that will change your life forever. 50 years ago, my predecessor stood in front of the first graduating class and probably uttered a similar phrase. But without hesitation, I can share that your journey has had some very significant twists. Because of those twists, I would like to share three things that have guided me through my own challenging times. Mourn the loss, mark the moments, and celebrate the struggle. I did not want today to be overshadowed by the events of the last few months, but ignoring the uncomfortable doesn't make it go away. In the words of the Dalai Lama, when you lose, don't lose the lesson. 3 months ago, for far too many of us, life was on autopilot. The pace was so hectic, we didn't even notice what was happening around us. You were probably struggling to balance your classwork with your job, and trying to find time to go out with your friends. And then there were the family obligations. Mom, do I really have to go? I was going to fill in the blank with something a lot more fun. Remember how busy you were? It was almost like, do the thing, take the picture, post it, share it, and repeat. We all walked around in a state of perpetual exhaustion, and we didn't even know it. And then all of a sudden, life stopped. And then it started again, but it was different. On Friday, March 11th, without a thought, you walked out of your classroom and you said to your friends, bye, see you after break. On Monday after the break, instead of walking across the campus, you now walked across the living room and your kitchen table was your classroom. And you shared it with your little sister. And your classmates were 1-inch by 1-inch squares on a monitor. You were asking, when am I going to see my friends? And when is everything going to go back to normal? And the scary part was the people who used to have the answers were now asking the same questions. The hospitality trip to Italy, maybe that'll take place next year. The baseball tournament to Florida, your uniform is still pressed in the closet. The play, the concerts, and even the parades canceled. Many last times never happened, and you eventually realized, for you, they never would. So I hope you acknowledge and mourn these milestone moments because they deserve the honor. Mourn the loss, mark the moments, and celebrate the struggle. In theater, marking a moment is a technique used to emphasize a significant moment in a scene. Now, it can be done through slow motion or freeze frame or even music. You know what that sounds like. The music gets louder and you know a key moment is going to happen. This is a moment in your life, and there'll be many, many more. But mark this moment. Look around. I mean, really look around and close your eyes and take a virtual picture. Make a mark on your life journey. Because despite of all of the obstacles, today, you achieved something great. You did it. And it matters a lot. There is a gift in the struggle. And Brookdale class of 2020, you won the lottery. Do you remember the first time you ate ice cream, or the first time your toes touched the ocean, or the first time you got a victory royale in Fortnite? Probably not, because either those events took place a long time ago or because they were easy. Now, do you remember the first time that you stood in front of a class and had to deliver a speech? or the time or finding the courage to lean in for the first kiss, or practicing all season because you wanted to make the team, and the feeling when you searched for your name on the roster and realized it wasn't there. Life isn't made in the easy. Life becomes life in the hard. Nothing is ever lost. Every experience, every challenge you accept makes you who you are. Today isn't about COVID-19, but she is part of your tapestry. She has made an indelible mark on your life. Kim Stanley Robinson, a writer for The New Yorker, said, "The virus is rewriting our imaginations. What felt impossible has become thinkable." We all struggle, and you will continue to do so as long as you live. You must decide that there is value in the process, and it can make you stronger, more resilient, or compassionate. We hope that your time here has fueled your learning mindset, making you far more interested in not just learning to perform, but also expanding your knowledge and being curious about how things work, how people think and feel, especially those who are different from you. Because you will be more adaptable in new and different situations and less fazed by failure. And these are the characteristics you will need because you are going to face new, difficult challenges that you haven't met before throughout your life. It is because of the events of the last few months that you will be the ones to help us reach the impossible. You are the chosen ones. You are the ones that were given the gift of struggle so that you could lead us to a better place. We need you. We need your strength and your vulnerability and your grit, empathy, curiosity, and creativity to help us solve hard problems. We need your learning mindset to help us become better people, a better society, and a better world. So mourn the loss, mark the moment, and celebrate the struggle. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, congratulations to the 50th graduating class of Brookdale Community College.
On this, the 50th anniversary of the first graduating class of Brookdale Community College, we are introducing a new tradition. Each year, a student is elected by their peers to serve on the Board of Trustees. The primary role of the student trustee is to be the voice of the students. Last year, the outgoing trustee, Victoria Catalona, presented me with a journal filled with thoughts and advice from her year of service. As I leave the office, I will do the same. This year, we decided to include the ceremony during graduation. Today, I am presenting the first Triangle Award to my successor, Hannah Walker. The term triangle honors our history, a triangle of land, and the progression from student to graduate to student trustee. Please join me in congratulating Hannah Walker as the first Triangle Award recipient.
I now ask one of our graduates, Rebecca Nastro, to come to the podium and share some remarks with her fellow graduates. Rebecca made a tremendous impact at Brookdale. As president of the Student Life Board, Rebecca was a leader in ensuring the vibrancy of campus life and extracurricular activities to enhance the educational experience at Brookdale. Becky, thank you for your leadership and making a difference in the lives of your peers.
Thank you, President Stout. It's really an honor. Welcome, faculty, students, and family members. I know this is not what you envisioned your graduation to be. However, despite what's going on in the world, we are still going to celebrate a very special day. My name is Rebecca Nastro, and you may know me as Becky Nastro, president of the Student Life Board at Brookdale Community College. Brookdale has been more than a school to us. It has been our connection to meeting new people from all around the world. Random people in classes have turned into college buddies. Some people find their loved ones, and other ones find themselves. Possibilities at Brookdale are endless. When you pursue your career or continue your education, you're going to look back and thank Brookdale. Skills that you'll need for the rest of your life were tried out here first. Those skills include prioritizing, using the resources you're given, and taking the initiative. Because in the end, only benefits you. Through joining clubs of becoming board members, you have practiced these skills, readying yourself for what comes next. But as our long, strange break was extended week after week, a truth began to settle in. We were now part of historic time, which, trust me, sounds way cooler than living through it. Remote learning became the new normal for students and faculty, a large number which had never done anything like this before. Despite the huge change to our college experience, we adapted and overcame it. Life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you respond to it. While the world we knew was changing outside, we were still putting in the work, studying for endless hours, asking help from professors, and trying to figure out how to make study groups on Zoom. You knew that this pandemic wasn't going to stop you. You were on a mission, and the achievements and experiences you have earned will follow you. Think about your next move. How can I make myself successful? Consider carefully your choices and be aware of potential results and consequences of each decision. Do these outcomes get me closer to where I want to be or who I want to be? You have your own key to success. It all depends on what door you open with it. We succeeded and graduated through these conditions. What could stop us now? The class of 2020 is historic. We are the class that kept going until we succeeded. Motivation is hard to find these days, even when it is uncertain. We need to find motivation and joy in the small things. We will look back and we'll see those small little lights led us through the darkness to where we are today. Eleanor Roosevelt once said, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." And I believe that we are well on our way to making our dreams a reality. Success starts at Brookdale, and Class 2020, you are an example of that. Congratulations, Class of 2020.
Thank you, Rebecca, for those beautiful words, and congratulations on your graduation today. The Outstanding Student Awards were created in 1980 to recognize outstanding student achievement, community service, and personal accomplishments. Students are selected by the faculty from their respective institutes and are known to be distinguished students. Congratulations to this year's Outstanding Student Award winners. They include Outstanding Students in Humanities, Veronique Manfredini and Emily Brown. Outstanding Students in Health Science, Gerald Salugin. Outstanding Student in Social Science and Business, Allison Ligas and Maria Monson. Outstanding Student in STEM, Rachel Sosinski and Margaret Hillier. Please allow me to say a few words about each of our Outstanding Student Award winners. Emily Brown plans to pursue a career in art after earning her associate's degree in fine arts at Brookdale. "The art department here is incredible," said Emily. "The faculty and staff are compassionate and knowledgeable. They always guided and encouraged me to do my absolute best with each assignment." Emily was a visible presence on campus and worked at the Art Gallery, the Humanities Institute office, and the Scroll and Pen bookstore. She also taught art to children as part of a summer camp program. She said working with children reinforced her interest and dedication to make a career in the arts. In supporting Emily's application for the Outstanding Student Award, Professor Marie Maber said Emily quickly learned how to install exhibits in the art gallery and had a terrific eye and great work ethic. Carol DiBuccio, Institute Administrator in the Humanities Division, added that "you only need to spend a short time with Emily to see her dedication and love of everything Brookdale." Professor Claire Smuga said, "Emily stood out for her cheerful nature, insightful questions, and as someone who is mature beyond her years." Emily said that "the encouragement, respect, and compassion that I received at Brookdale led me to become a more confident person and a successful student." Congratulations, Emily. Allison Ligas earned her associate's degree in fashion merchandising and will continue her studies this fall at LIM College in New York City. At Brookdale, Allison was part of the Honors Program and served as a mentor to incoming students. She also participated in the Fashion Club and worked on the spring fashion shows. She credits both activities with honing her study and time management skills while instilling confidence. Knowing that the transition from high school to higher education is challenging, Allie opted to serve as an honors mentor. Allison said she remembered being nervous and unsure when she started at Brookdale. "I didn't want my peers to ever feel that way," she said, "and I felt that sharing my story, including that sometimes failure leads to the greatest success, might inspire others." She found a welcoming environment and succeeded in and outside of the classroom. In supporting Allison's application for the Outstanding Student Award, Professor Jonathan Moschberger and Beth Hochberg, adjunct instructor in fashion marketing, described Allison as an innovative thinker with a genuine passion for the fashion industry, and added that Allison possesses great leadership abilities in addition to her collaborative work with her peers. "I will carry the lessons I have earned at Brookdale and encourage others in the same positive, compassionate, and respectful way," said Allison. Congratulations, Allie. Margaret Hillier said science and her area of focus, chemistry, are fun and can bring positive change to the world. After earning her associate in science degree, Margaret will transfer to Rutgers University in the fall and complete her bachelor's degree. Margaret does not plan on stopping there and plans on earning a doctorate in chemistry as well. She also wants to mentor young women who possess the same passion for science but are uncertain about next steps. Margaret said, "Because of Brookdale's supportive faculty, I have become a confident and proud woman pursuing a career in STEM." She wants to demonstrate to others that you don't have to come from a perfect or privileged background to achieve your dream. Margaret wants to inspire others as she was inspired and to encourage them not to let go of their aspirations, but to pursue them. In supporting Margaret's application for the Outstanding Student Award, Professor Tom Berkey said that she's reliable, trusted by those around her, and has an impressive aptitude for learning chemistry. Congratulations, Margaret. Maria Monson has overcome many challenges and obstacles in her personal and academic journey after leaving her native country, Guatemala, to start a new life in the United States. She had to adapt quickly to the new culture and learn a new language. Her resolve led her to Brookdale, where she demonstrated her skills and talents in and outside of the classroom. After earning her associate's degree in business and administration, Maria will continue her studies in finance analytics at Rutgers University. Her ambitions don't end there. She may pursue a master's degree in the field or opt to study law. Maria cited her involvement in the Women in Learning and Leadership Program, WILL, and the Honors Program as providing an anchor and foundation while instilling confidence. She served as WILL Vice President and as an Honors Mentor and ambassador, and logged more than 100 hours of community service. Maria said, "Graduating Brookdale is bittersweet," and noted that it was at Brookdale that I grew from a scared young adult into an empowered, outspoken, and independent young woman. Congratulations, Maria. Rachel Sosinski credits her time at Brookdale with helping her to chart a new course when she enrolled in 2018. She always had an interest in engineering and decided now was the good time to make a go of it. She has staked her claim in her field of choice, earning her associate's degree in mechanical engineering. She will continue her education at Rutgers University with plans to earn a bachelor's degree in aerospace engineering and a master's degree in mechanical engineering before embarking on a career in spacecraft design. At Brookdale, Rachel was active in numerous clubs and activities, including the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, the Engineering Club, the Physics Club, and the Women in Engineering, Technology, and Science Club. She also served as a tutor to her fellow chemistry students. In endorsing Rachel's application for the Outstanding Student Award, Professor Nancy Liu described Rachel as an excellent student, hardworking, enthusiastic, and cheerful, who was always very warm and thoughtful. She added that it was a pleasure to have Rachel as a student in her classes. "My experience at Brookdale has been amazing," said Rachel. "The atmosphere here really encourages students to explore and succeed, and choosing Brookdale has been one of the best decisions I've made." Congratulations, Rachel. As a husband, father, and full-time emergency medical technician, Gerald Suligan successfully managed many priorities in earning his degree in respiratory therapy at Brookdale. Because of his achievements, the New Jersey Society for Respiratory Care presented him with its Student Excellence Award. Gerald said, "Providing care is his passion. It's reflected in his work as he trains many of his fellow EMTs." Gerald plans on continuing his studies and working in the field as a respiratory therapist. He would also like to teach someday to develop future generations of respiratory therapists. Gerald credits the respiratory therapy faculty, laboratory, and clinical instructors for high standards of teaching and genuine concern for all students. In supporting Gerald's application, Professor Joanne Boyd described Gerald as someone who is always willing to assist others and whose passion and dedication inspires others. "Attending Brookdale was one of the best decisions I have ever made," said Gerald. "What a life-changing adventure it has been." Congratulations, Gerald. Veronique Manfredini earned her associate's degree with a double major in business administration and English. She plans to pursue a career as a writer, editor in the publishing industry, or English professor. Veronique is a prime example of how Brookdale can be a catalyst for success, that by starting here, you can go anywhere. Veronique will be attending Columbia University this fall. Veronique earned numerous accolades for her academic achievements. She was named to the 2020 New Jersey All-State Academic Team, one of 38 students and Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society members statewide to be so honored. She was also named a 2020 Oberndorf Scholar by the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society, one of 7 students internationally to earn this award. Veronique was involved in numerous activities on campus and held several leadership positions. She was chair of special events of Brookdale's chapter of Phi Theta Kappa and served as president of the New Jersey chapter for the 2019-2020 academic year. In addition, she was an active member in the Women in Learning and Leadership Club and Collage, the student literary magazine. She was a student ambassador and wrote for The Current, the student newspaper. In supporting Veronique's application, Professor Jane Semeca said, "In my 25 years of teaching, Veronique is one of the best students I have ever had in my class. She distinguishes herself with outstanding grades as well as generous collaboration with her classmates. She's conscientious and commits herself 100% to her work. Veronique describes Brookdale as her second home. I'm a different person than when I started at Brookdale," said Veronique. "I'm stronger, more prepared, and not scared." She said that Brookdale prepared her academically and in many ways giving her a place to grow and to thrive. Congratulations, Veronique. We are pleased this year to confer an honorary associate's degree in letters on 2 individuals, Thomas F. Hayes and Roy Lamana, for their achievements and service. Tom's involvement in numerous nonprofit organizations in Monmouth County and throughout New Jersey is well known. His dedication, enthusiasm, time, and talent on various boards and agencies have made him a positive impact on the lives of thousands. Tom serves on more than 25 boards and 24 committees for nonprofit agencies in Monmouth, Ocean, and Morris County areas. He is a visible presence and an active participant in organizations such as United Way, YMCA, Ronald McDonald House, Monmouth Park Charity Fund, Monmouth Ocean Development Council, Senior Citizens Activity Network, Human Service Advisory Council, and the American Cancer Association. Having earned a BS in architecture from the Catholic University of America, Tom has assisted several organizations with facilities planning. Tom is the Director of Customer and Community Relations for New Jersey Natural Gas Company. He is responsible for community outreach and manages the New Jersey Natural Gas Charity, and serves as a liaison with the New Jersey Board of Public Utilities. He and his staff handle programs ranging from home ownership and energy assistance programs to volunteer and educational initiatives throughout New Jersey Natural Gas service area. Prior to his current position, Tom headed the company's Economic Development Department. He has held executive positions in several business organizations, including Chambers of Commerce and Urban Enterprise Zone boards. Tom and his wife, Regina, purchased and restored the childhood home of Stephen Crane, author of The Red Badge of Courage. They established a museum and community program venue in the Asbury Park home. Tom and Regina are blessed with three wonderful children. The Hayeses are often engaged as a family in volunteer work throughout the community. Thank you, Tom, and congratulations.
Thank you, Board of Trustees of Brookdale Community College, and your phenomenal leader, President Stout. I'm greatly humbled and certainly honored to get this honorary degree from Brookdale Community College. It is quite a pleasure, considering that not only did I take some courses here at Brookdale, but also all three of my children have attended Brookdale and taken courses here as well. To those we are celebrating today, you are graduating in one of the most unusual times in our country's history. Let this be a lesson to you, that the future is never certain, but you must always be ready to adapt and change. Your time at Brookdale has helped you prepare for the future and whatever it may bring. I was once in your seat, and when I was planning to go to college, my father told me, make sure you get your degree. It doesn't matter what you get it in, you can always change, things can always change in your future, but get that degree. That college degree is very important, and what you're doing and the path that you're on is leading you in that right direction. You can always change your mind. My degree happened to be in architecture, and I worked in that field for many years and enjoyed it thoroughly. However, when I got a job at New Jersey Natural Gas Company over 30 years ago, I was brought into the facilities area, but eventually was asked to head up our economic development department, which was a little frightening for me. It was different. So it was helping folks in our community, help bringing businesses into the community, helping creating jobs in our community. It was a wonderful experience. I learned so much, and I am so grateful that I took that position. And later on, they offered me the current position that I'm in, which is Director of Customer and Community Relations for New Jersey Natural Gas. And with this company being such a community-minded company, that was again a nervous area for me to take over, but it worked out wonderfully. And again, it just goes to show that you can start out in a certain field or with a certain thing in mind, but you have the ability to change your mind or change direction at any point in your future. So don't be worried about that at this point. And to all of you, I just want to say congratulations. 2020 is a great year to graduate. It's a very unique, one-of-a-kind time. Again, with these uncertain and crazy times, you are in this very special year, a year that all of us will remember forever. So with that, I say do a good job. Wherever you end up working, be trustworthy and be honest and hardworking, and you'll do very well. And I wish you the best as you go forward, and congratulations for this great accomplishment.
Throughout his career, Roy LaManna has coupled his entrepreneurial drive with community partnership. His business success has been recognized nationally, while his philanthropic activities have made an impact on our local communities. Roy is the Chief Executive Officer and co-founder of Vidya, an Inc. 500 company. Vidya has played a major role in launching the careers of music artists Lil Pump, Fetty Wap, Post Malone, and Bad Baby prior to major record label offers. His company's cutting-edge technology is well known and very much in demand throughout the industry. Prior to launching Vidya, Roy founded Trendsetter Media and Marketing. The company is responsible for marketing some of the biggest names in music today, including Lady Gaga, Maroon 5, Bebe Rexha, Andy Grammer, Major Lazer, and others. Roy was recently named a top entrepreneur by Inc. magazine and has been featured in Forbes, The Huffington Post, Rolling Stone, and The Wall Street Journal. In November 2019, Deloitte released its annual North America Technology Fast 500, a ranking of the fastest growing North American companies in technology sectors. Vidya, headquartered at Bellworks, was ranked 175. Roy is an active leader in the community. He has partnered with local high schools, universities, and the NORC All-Star organization to create mentorships and internship programs for disadvantaged youth. He's playing a leading role in helping others achieve their dreams and is cultivating the technology leaders of tomorrow. He also serves on the TJ Martell's Music for Cure Foundation board and remains an active supporter of the local nonprofit organization, such as Princeton's Eden Autism Organization. Thank you, Roy, and congratulations.
How are you doing? Congratulations to Brookdale Class of 2020. Thank you so much for honoring me at today's event. Just want to give a quick antidote to the fellow graduates out there by telling a very brief story on my background and more specifically what I went through, where I feel like it's a very similar situation. So all the graduates right now are certainly probably very concerned due to the recent, political and financial and economic climate that's going on. When I started my business in 2008, I had a high school diploma and a Brookdale education to my name. And I spent many nights, when I first started in April 2018, kind of staring at the ceiling, wondering, what was in store for me and kind of being very concerned about, what the future held. At that point, in 2008, they're talking about, this being the largest recession since the Great Depression. I remember thinking, what horrible timing, my entire career had due to the fact that, I was starting out what seemingly seemed to be the bottom. What soon followed was 12 years of economic growth. I had a couple advantages that I was able to kind of lean into. One of most was the idea that I really didn't have any debt and that, the Brookdale education allowed me to really kind of play, the long game. That was really beneficial in the idea that I was able to early on, take opportunities that came my way, not because they were, financially lucrative early on, but because they laid the foundation that would set my career on its current path. More importantly, I learned that these things kind of work in cycles. They work in waves, and just like any wave, you kind of need to catch it at the right time. And so over these last 12 years, having seemingly started at the bottom, I was able to kind of build into it. And now as we enter, probably what is almost a more turbulent time, I was able to be mindful from what I learned early on in my career, that things won't always be great, and that over the next 40 or 50 years in which you'll be establishing yourself as a professional, you're gonna see this happen. It's gonna happen once or twice or even three times, and you need to be mindful and prepare for it. So, the one thing I would like to have everyone just take away from this is that everyone should just be really playing for the long game and really, learning and taking away, from, the education that you have and leveraging that to create opportunities for you over the next several years. So once again, thank you and congratulations to the class of 2020.
Each year at commencement, we acknowledge successful Brookdale graduates. We are pleased today to honor two individuals, Sheila Wexler, class of 1978, and Kevin Garrison, class of 1994. Sheila Wexler's efforts have enabled thousands of individuals to overcome their addictions and to regain control of their lives. Sheila is one of our nation's pioneers in the treatment of compulsive gambling. In 1987, she developed and implemented a compulsive gambling inpatient program at New Hope Foundation in Marlboro, New Jersey. Her groundbreaking work has helped individuals to restore their connections to their families and to their professional careers. She graduated from Brookdale with her associate's degree in applied science in human services in 1978. At this time, gambling addiction programs were virtually non-existent. However, Sheila saw a need and was determined to make a difference. She began her professional career with an internship at New Hope Foundation, an inpatient treatment center serving those with substance abuse disorders. What started out as an internship developed into a lengthy and meaningful career. She retired as deputy director of New Hope in 1994. Sheila is licensed, a licensed certified alcohol and drug counselor, and a certified compulsive gambling counselor. Counselors nationwide use the chart that she developed, tracing the effects of compulsive gambling on the family. Together with her husband, Arnie, the Wexlers have provided extensive training on compulsive, problem, and underage gambling to more than 40,000 gaming employees. The couple has authored responsible gaming programs for major gaming companies and presented educational workshops nationally and internationally. Sheila is the proud mother of 3 adult children and 4 adult grandchildren.
Thank you very much for this honor. It means a lot to me, and I will cherish it. I came to Brookdale as a mother of 3 children in my 30s, returning to school with a lot of fear and a lot of apprehension. Brookdale took care of all of that. They gave me a wonderful education. They gave me knowledge and support and direction. And I wound up as an intern in New Hope Foundation, where I found my passion for helping addicted people and their families. That has continued for all my life until this day, and I am so ever grateful to Brookdale for that beginning. I want to say congratulations to the class of 2020. May all your dreams come true, and never be afraid to dream. Thank you again. I truly appreciate this honor.
Kevin Garrison answered the call to serve his nation and has dedicated his life to improving the plight of homeless in our midst. After serving for 3 years in the Army, including in Operations Desert Shield and Desert Storm, Kevin attended Brookdale. He soon discovered his passion and a new mission when he established the Blessing Bag Brigade. The nonprofit organization aims to provide basic necessities to the homeless population at several locations in New Jersey. Blessing Bag Brigade's mission is to provide some comfort to the homeless. The organization collects socks, snack food, water bottles, shampoo, body wash and soap, and toothbrushes, travel-sized toothpaste, and other basic necessities for distribution to the homeless. Blessing Bag Brigade has nearly 20 drop-off locations throughout Monmouth County. Thanks to the generosity of its donors, the Blessing Bag Brigade has distributed more than 49,000 blessing bags since December 2016 and served more than 8,000 meals. The Blessing Bag Brigade began distributing bags 5 nights a week in New York City and then soon focused on several locations in New Jersey, including Newark, Middletown, Asbury Park, Ocean Grove, Freehold, Keensburg, Atlantic Highlands, and other Jersey Shore areas. Their mission has since expanded to help kids with special needs to enhance their life skills. The Blessing Bag Brigade is involved in 5 Jersey Shore area schools. The children receive, divide, and pack the supplies into gallon bags. The organization coordinates that on a monthly and bi-monthly basis. Kevin has said, "Our compassion proves to the homeless that we care and that people do want to help." Thank you, Kevin, and congratulations.
Thank you very much for having me here. Thank you so much for this award. In 2016, I saw a social media post that was going to change my life forever. It was a picture of this. This was called a blessing bag or a hygiene bag. And as I was looking for a project to do for Christmas, I came across this bag. And what had happened was I gave out a bunch of bags at Christmas time, and people were excited about what was going on, and they asked if they could do more. So what appeared to be just a quick Christmas project turned into a project of monument proportions. What had happened with this is, not only did we start handing out some of them, I started telling stories about places and when, where things were going, and people joined in. We wound up becoming a force of about 4,000 members. We've handed out over 60,000 of these bags. We've actually started soup kitchens around the area. So we've served over 10,000 meals. You know, this has become a really human interest, or interesting, I should say, project. And, you know, we're just so delighted that we're able to be recognized for this. And I know it's me as the alumni personally, but, you know, this is bigger than me. This is about a group. This is about people coming together to do something good. And this continues today. We've been around for a short amount of time. And, you know, Brookdale was a big part of me becoming me. It really was. I came out of the Army, not sure what I was going to do. Came into Brookdale and floated around here for a few years and learned a lot. The education I got, the different things. One in particular, professor of business law, he used to tell us on a continuous basis, have self-worth. And if you don't remember anything from today, remember having self-worth. Because having self-worth, it just puts you on a different level. You know, it gives you confidence. It helps you when you fail. It helps you do the things that ordinarily people can't do. You know, having good self-worth is so important, and you're all worth it, and you all should be proud of yourselves for what's accomplished here today and for what you will accomplish. So thank you very much. I appreciate this award, and I'm utterly honored. Thank you.
I'm very happy to be here today to congratulate the graduates of 2020. I've been at Brookdale for many years and in education for many years, but I have never been prouder of our students than I have been in the last semester and how they have handled the situation that they are faced with today. Usually we would be here with pomp and circumstance and a very normal kind of program. This year it's different. I am very proud to be at Brookdale, and I've been at Brookdale for most of my career. I'm proud of our administration and leadership, our staff, and our faculty who are so committed to our students. I would like to thank all of our students, and especially those who are graduating this year and about to leave us as they continue their education at other institutions where they're very actively sought after by these institutions because they're outstanding. And thank and wish all of our other students continued good luck as we get through this serious time and re-enter a more normal situation in our education. Again, congratulations, class of 2020.
At this time of the year, graduates are happy and their families are full of pride for their accomplishments. Graduates, you have all worked hard to reach your goals. This year, you have had many moments that were both happy and sad. Remember that those moments are your life that will help you get to where you should be. This year, we celebrate Brookdale's 50th graduating class. It is an honor for me to congratulate the 2020 Brookdale graduates and wish you all happiness, good health, and success as you enter either a new educational institution or pursue your career in the world of work. Meet the challenges that you will have and will face and turn them into opportunities. Enjoy the time because it will be a memory that you will never forget. Congratulations, graduates. Be proud of what you have achieved, and don't forget to say thank you to those who have helped you along the way. And always remember to smile.
Dr. Stout, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Brookdale Community College, I present the class of 2020 and certify that they've met all of the requirements for their appropriate degrees and respectfully submit that such be conferred upon them.
By the authority vested in me by the State of New Jersey and the Board of Trustees of Brookdale Community College, I confer upon you the degrees as recommended.
Alexis Navarro. Abigail L. Holm. Abraham Coakley. Abigail Lynn Bird. Aaliyah Pandia.
Andrew Greenstein.
Alyssa Keating. Alonzo Olson. Brown. Amanda Angiolini. Amabel Delena. Allison Ligas. Augustin Alvarado.
Alma Plaza.
Anthony Halagunas. Anthony Lorenzo Giacchetti. Amanda Gabrielson. Brandon Spinner.
Annalise Salvador. Alyssa Frenser. Andrew Muller. Ashley Martinez. Ashley Fuchs. Anya Miles. Angelica Mejia. Ashley Batanko. Benjamin Lapretta. Arita Amin. Annalisa DiLorenzo. Ashley Lemon. Angelica Giuliani. Noah Rivera. Araceli Uranga. Brittany Fiola. Ashley Fiola. Arleth Zuniga. Bethany Barbieri. Brian Hickey. Woo! Beth Hink. Betty Moran. Bradley Mikhail Williams. Brianna Argant. Brianna Zalesnik. Inaya Preston. Bria Bristow. Brooke Simmons. Brittany Johnson. Cecilia Villanueva. Arkin. Brooke Golick. Katrin Scarlett Cavalier. Christopher Jedwinski. Cheryl Budnick.
Caitlin Faith.
Catherine Vecchio. Louisa Inagian. Chelsea Marie Rager. Yeah. Sharan Cocker. Christine DeNigris. Christopher Joyce. Dakota Abrams. Claire Eckel. Christian John Kokuza. Cooper Bain. Daniel McCormick. Dana Genovese. Dana Huggins.
Connor Mullen.
Daniel Mealy. Dana Huggins. Caitlin Felix. Kirsten O'Brien. David Valor. Dorothy Rapunkas.
Danielle Grudovich and Heidi.
Danielle Hora. Daniela Laviano. Don Fortunato.
Edward C. Allegra, the third.
Danielle Nasta. Desiree Medina. Devin Albers and Jennifer Albers. Denisha Manuel. Deborah Deanna. Danielle Holmes. Derek Ball. Helen Wan. Donald J. Cash. Edward Hawley. Elise Danielle Capelli. Dion New Love Kanda. Enrique Perez Lopez. Elizabeth Bragna. Eric Gorski. Gabrielle Rose Schenagel. Evelyn Villa Carrasco. Alexis Yu. Elizabeth Casimiro. Aaron McAvoy.
Aaron Crew.
Eric Reister. Eric Stiver. Enrique Reeves. Helen Megalablishvili. Aaron McGrath. Galen Santiago. Fiza Kieran. Gabrielle Anjos. Giulio Bianchi. Evan O'Brien. Emily Avila. Francisco Aguilar. Francesca Corcoquios. Holly Braverman. Frank Esposito IV. Francisco De Jesus. Gabriel Awulola. Gladys Rubio. Maximilian Cross. Heather Chavez. Gabriella Pizzicello. Gerald Sulagin. Hudson Etter. Our new trustee, Hannah Walker. Gabriella Viterbo. Isaac Holt. Jacqueline Genovese. Irvin Rodriguez. Harley Crosby. Jamal Meyer Smith. Gurneed Valmond. Jaina Swanin. Woo! Aquiles. James Maletto. Jamie Fierros. Janelle Monique Kemp. Jeffrey Liu. Jessica Kurtz. Jeremy Viruet. Jessica Alvarez. Jill Kuntz. Joshua Vincent Nichols. Jocelyn Martinez Carrion. John P. Bartow. Kathy Brazilli. Justin Reha. Joseph Bueller. Veronica Mendez. Jeffrey Serrano. Jodalyn Jacques-Pierre. Jose Cantero. Diane Gordon. Jonathan Shudo. Keely Mitchell. Caitlin Guckian. Kiera Bostic. Louis Costanza. Christine Quinn. Congratulations. Kristen DiCepolo. Carrie Rubino. Kevin Lopez. Kim Hampton. Kimberly Galvez. Lexi Rosen. Lizbeth Contreras. Lisa Catalfamo.
Olivia Catalfamo.
Liliana Ravello. Luis Ramirez. Esposito. Mark Sobey.
Leroy Benton.
Lily Callahan. Kyle Rodney. This year's outstanding student in business and social science, Maria Monson. Millennia Galloway. Mariah Reynolds. Luigi Rodriguez. Kofi B. Deborah. Manuel Morahan. Marissa Glickman. Marianne Abruzzi. Madison Miller. Marie Gladys Satut. Rachel Nehemiah Satut. Martine Fanfan. Maria Morrow. Mark McElvain. Matthew Colley. Matthew Hoser. Mark LaRosa. Michael Marquis. Megan O'Shea. Michael Keenan. Michael Ramirez. This year's outstanding student in STEM, Margaret Hillier. Michael Tucker. Matthew Totillo. Nathaniel Orsag.
Morgan Patella.
Megan Kaba. Natalia Jivora-Kavisky. Nicholas Del Grande.
Michelle Ward.
Michael Rangione. Nicole Puzo.
Congratulations. Thank you. You're welcome.
Nicholas Tortorici. Nikki Smith Falcone with Lucky. Nick Puglia. Christopher Landry. Nashe Carson. Najita Pierre. Najida Pierre. Nicole Carney. Winner of Outstanding Student in STEM, Rachel Sosinski. Nicole Trindaddy. Dallas Caraballo. Kiana Torres. Qureshi. Rachel Rue. Rebecca Throckmorton. Rufus Gomez. Rafael Maraquin. Rebecca Nunley. President of the Student Life Board, Rebecca Nastro. Samantha Moss.
Well done, well done.
Gisella Rosado. Woo!
Robert Key.
Maria Ramirez Dominguez. Ryan Lemberg. Shane Lemberg. Sabrina Arbus. Rebecca Urban. Rosalia Diazio. Rudolph Vitale. Ron Haney. Street Simos and Kenobi. Shane Kinnear. Samantha Relay. Sabrina Maisonette. Charisma Ubiera.
Shanae Stevens.
Tara Sullivan. Shannon Goodson. Skylar Weicker. Sherry Hendricks. Sonia D. Johnson. Sean B. Mack. Shanice Williams. Sasha Adnan. Taylor Parente. Suzanne Sokolowski. Sultan Abdelaziz. Sarah Abdelaziz. Taylor Trapani. Tahani Mitchell. Siobhan Jones. Tatiana Madera. Tyler Shaughnessy. Thomas James McDonald. Paige Hardy. Teresa Gary. Tawana Moore. Tyler Lewis. Trisha Arzadon. Sirza Yvette Almontero. Vermel Prince. Tiffany Johnson. Brody Chazanoff. Tiffany Wilson. Veronica Rager. Vita Osman. Valentine Kellerman. William Shannon.
Victoria Santos.
Watkins Moisey. Zara Crenshaw. Yolette Joseph. Zion Cozart.
President Stout and Board of Trustees Chair Tracy Abbey White, I present graduates for the degrees of Associate in Arts, Associate in Applied Science, Associate in Science, Associate in Fine Arts, and Certificates. Now, graduates, you look great, but something's not quite right. College students wear the tassel on the right, but college graduates wear the tassel on the left. Please move the tassel to the left, and congratulations to the class of 2020.
Graduates, let me conclude by extending congratulations from the entire Brookdale Community College to you for overcoming extraordinary obstacles and achieving your goals. You make us so proud. You have navigated through difficult times over these past few months. I commend you for your focus and your resilience. Now, as Brookdale alumni, remember that you are part of an enormous Brookdale family. As you take your next steps, whether in your career or at one of our university partners, don't forget to tell everyone your success started at Brookdale. We wish you nothing but the best in all of your future endeavors. Don't forget to stay connected with us. Join the Alumni Association. Come back and visit. We thrive on your success. We only ask that you pay it forward by being the best ambassadors for Brookdale that you can possibly be. Congratulations, class of 2020. Yeah.